plastic that I like to use is plastic that you can get at like Publix or any grocery store that you put your produce in. Nice and thin, malleable. Now I'm going to try something a little bit different that I haven't tried before. I'm going to do a plug in the shape of a flower. This I got at Hobby Lobby, I think. And you can see that when you press the button, it pops out the clay that you just cut. So I'm going to put that on here. In all the way. That's kind of a thick piece of clay for this, but come out and kind of get an idea of what that looks like with the plastic on it. And take the plastic off, see if it cut through the way I wanted it to. It did. Did a beautiful job. I'm just pulling it out of the piece right now, and this is what I have. It's a really neat clay plug. Now, here is my handy dandy logo. I had this made on Etsy, and I think they did it through some sort of a 3D printer or something, because it's tiny. I ordered two more that are bigger, but this will do for now. I'm going to go ahead and put my logo on the bottom of this. See how cool that is? And then I'm going to score this again and score the back of this and add that to the bottom of my owl. Of course, I need to slip it as well with my magic slip mixture. If I did this all the way closed, it would make it stand up a little higher, but I really kind of want to keep it a little bit broader like this. I'm going to put my little piece on there. Close in around it. Make sure it's nice and even centered. And then just pressing it a little bit. Just kind of a nice little touch to put the on the bottom of the pottery. Let's see what this looks like. Here, you can see that it's cracking a little bit. It's doing it a lot right here. And so I think maybe what I'll do is wet that down a little bit. If you excuse me just for a second, I will get a sponge, a wet sponge. Having a sink in your pottery room is a really handy thing. And I like the two-sided sinks because you can do stuff in one while you're drying stuff in the other. So I'm going to use my sponge, and I'm just going to go over these areas right here. You can see the difference. I don't know if you can see it from there, but you can see where, you know, it was kind of cracked and dry looking, and now it doesn't look that way at all. I'm a little concerned about this one standing up a little bit higher. One really great way to measure that is to use another piece of wood, and you can see that it's way wonked, and that's going to make the whole thing kind of wonked, if that's a word. It looks to me like this side might be just a little bit on the low side, so it needs to be more. This side's still really high. Is scrape a little bit of this off, because you know, having a tilty vase or anything is not very visually appealing. So I like to try to get it as close to untilty as possible in these early stages. That to me still looks pretty tilty. Looks like that side's still pretty high. So I'm going to